Hi everyone, this is Zara from Vaishi and today I will be talking about pacifiers. We have decided to do a small four-part series on pacifiers because it's something that a lot of people are in two minds about. All moms think that, you know, should I use a pacifier, should I not, I'm breastfeeding, should I still use a pacifier, and all such questions. So I thought that it would be really nice to do a four-part series on this, wherein we will be including a popular myth surrounding pacifiers, do's and don'ts regarding pacifiers, how to wean your child off a pacifier, very important, and of course the pros and cons about using a pacifier as well. Today the topic that I will be talking about is the do's and don'ts about using a pacifier. Starters, let me tell all of you that my daughter was on the pacifier for about a little over a year. I guess around 14 to 15 months is the duration of when she used a pacifier. And the main reason that I went for it was because I was unable to breastfeed properly. I was able to breastfeed Max for about a month or so, and then, you know, I couldn't produce enough milk for her. So usually what happens is that a child also breastfeeds to soothe themselves, it pacifies them, so to speak. And since my daughter didn't have that option, we decided to go in for a pacifier. First off, when you decide to use a pacifier, you have to just, you know, make up your mind that the weaning process, whenever you choose to end it, is not going to be an easy task, whether your child is going to be just 1 year old, 2 years old, or even 3 or 4 years old. The process of weaning is going to be very tough. It is by no means easier than weaning your child off their finger or your breast. It is going to be just as difficult. So prepare yourself mentally for that in advance. Sterilization is extremely important, guys. Do remember that if you're using a pacifier for your child, sterilize the pacifier on a daily basis or even multiple times a day, depending on how many you have at hand. If you have spares then you may not need to sterilize them again and again during the day. You can do it probably just once a day in the morning and you'd be free. Which brings me to my next point, which is please do keep spare pacifiers at hand, especially if your child is exclusively on the pacifier. It becomes easier because your child will just, you know, probably take a pacifier, rub it against the wall, or it might just fall down from their mouth and hit the floor. So it becomes, and you know what happens is that if you take it right then and go to sterilize it, it's likely that your child is going to cry bloody murder until you get it back to them, and that can be extremely painful, I know. So, you know, it's good if you have a spare one at hand, so that if you have to take one to sterilize, you have the other one to give your child. This is an extremely important point. There are a lot of friends of mine who have tried to introduce the pacifier right from the beginning, thinking that, you know, it would give them a bit of a relief from breastfeeding. But what happens is that a newborn is still confused about how to breastfeed. It's as difficult for them as it is for us as moms. So introducing a pacifier at that point in time isn't really the right thing to do. Once they get the hang of breastfeeding, then yes, then it's the perfect time to introduce your child to a pacifier as well. There will not be any nipple confusion, as they call it. An orthodontic pacifier is exactly what I did. Now, as a lot of you may know, when we were children, the only option of a soother or a pacifier was those ones with the bulb shaped nipples. Those were the only options available to us, and what a lot of people used to say was that they could cause buck teeth. Well, I'm not very sure that that's true at all. I personally feel that that happens only if your child uses it until an advanced age, not really when they're babies. But anyways, you know, these orthodontic pacifiers are said to be really good in that regard because of the way they are shaped. I do have one that I kept especially to do this video. I threw out the other ones because I weaned off my daughter. So this is what they look like. It has this slanted nipple. Yeah, this pacifier that I got, actually all of the ones that I got are from this brand called First Step. It usually has a little cartoon character right here, but it's faded after such a long usage. This is the lid, which clips on really easily, and this is the attachable string, which I attach to my daughter's top. It's really easily attachable, and you do get spares as well available separately. One of the main reasons why I suggest buying a pacifier with one of these attachable clips and the lids is because, you know, without this little string, you tend to run the risk of this pacifier falling down repeatedly, because your baby isn't going to really have a very strong grip at the beginning. So if you can just, you know, clip this onto their top or their romper, that's it. You know, you don't have to worry about it falling to the floor time and time again. The lid, of course, is super useful, because especially if you're traveling and after your baby falls asleep, you just pop it out, and you know, it feels a little weird to put this back in your bag because of the risk of infections and all those little, you know, fungusy things attaching itself to your pacifier. So this lid protects the pacifier totally and helps you ensure that your child is farthest away from any risk of infection. You know, especially those of the older generation tend to say, you know, if you're going to use a soother, then fill it up with honey or something, which is something that I'm totally against. Part of the reason is because honey itself is not allowed for children right at the beginning, considering that it's mostly adulterated nowadays, and using that can just cause a lot of viruses to enter your child's body. The final tip is to remove it from your child's mouth once they are asleep. A lot of us use pacifiers only to put our children to sleep, and this is one thing that my pediatrician suggested, was that once your baby is asleep, just slide it out gently, so that, you know, they don't keep on at it, and the risk of addiction is lessened quite a lot. Well, moms, these were the do's and don'ts with regards to using a pacifier to your child. If you know of any others, please do mention it in the comment section below, and do hit the like button if you have liked this video as well. Subscribe to our channel if you want to see some more awesome videos which we have coming up, and as always, be safe. See you next time.